Science and craft. We're combining the two things again today for another science-based craft project. So pretty. I feel like most of my science projects are either goo or something with crystals. Hey guys, Ray Pahar from Get Crafty Crafty, and today we're going to be doing another science-based craft project. We're going to be making eggshell geodes, and if you guys aren't familiar with what a geode is, it's this naturally occurring rock found in nature that is usually hollow on the inside, and when you crack it open, it is lined with a crystal or mineral interior. This is a quartz geode that I cracked open during one of my summer trips this past summer at Yellowstone. But instead of waiting a really long time for these geodes to form, finding them, and then cracking them open, we're going to be making our very own geode using some materials that you guys can find in your local grocery market. Let's go ahead and get started with today's project. The items that you'll need for today's project include some white glue, a paintbrush, access to hot water, assorted food coloring, alum powder. You can find this at the spice section of the grocery market, or you can buy it in bulk. I'll have links to this in the description below. A large heat-safe container or a beaker, and some cleaned out eggshells. Before we create our geodes, you want to make sure that your eggshells are completely dried and have been cleaned off. Remove any of the excess small pieces on the side so that they don't flake off when you're making your geodes. Using your white glue, apply a small amount inside your egg, and then use your paintbrush to spread it out evenly. If needed, apply more glue to the sides to make sure that everything on the inside of your egg is completely covered. Once the inside of your egg has been completely coated with glue, take your alum powder and apply a generous amount of alum powder onto the inside of your egg. Roll the alum powder around to make sure that everything is coated on the inside, and then shake off any excess. You want to wait for the glue to dry overnight before moving on to the next step. I went ahead and made an eggshell that already had the alum powder dried and glued on the inside. In your large container or your beaker, you're going to add about 30 drops of food coloring, or about half a tablespoon worth of food coloring into your beaker. I found that it's actually easier to use the bigger containers of food coloring compared to squeezing out 30 little drops. You can add about half a tablespoon to a tablespoon of food color. The more color you add, the deeper the color will be in your geode. Next, add 2 cups of close to boiling water to your food coloring. You want to be very careful when you're doing this. If you need the help or supervision of an adult, make sure you ask for it. Next, you're going to add 3/4 cup of your alum powder into your solution. Make sure all of your alum powder has completely dissolved into your solution before moving on to the next step. Once everything has been mixed together and all the alum powder has dissolved into your solution, you're going to take your egg and you're going to carefully place it inside your solution. Gently place it on top and then push it down so that it goes to the bottom of your beaker or large container. You'll want to let this sit aside for 12 to 15 hours so that the crystals can form onto your eggshell. I went ahead and made 2 eggshells so that I would have something to show at the end of this project. For this project, I found that you could use either brown eggs or white eggs, and it doesn't really matter what color egg you use, just because the egg itself is actually going to absorb a lot of the color from the food coloring. The only trick to this project is you do want to crack your egg in half this way versus the traditional way that most people do, just because you want to have more area for your egg to actually hold a lot of the alum powder on so that the crystals can grow onto your egg. This project is pretty much possible through a process called sedimentation, and that's when there's so many little particles of your alum powder floating around into your solution that once it's been heated up and then slowly cools down, the little particles want to find a place to rest on and then recreate its crystal structure, which it originally came from. It's a little confusing, it's a fun little project, but we actually did something similar to this in a previous video, which was our rock candy, which you can see right over here. We did something similar, and that one was a little bit more edible. Alum powder is often used for pickling and various other things, and that's why you can find it in the spice section of your grocery market, but I probably wouldn't recommend eating this just because it's filled with a lot of food color and it's been sitting inside an egg and you don't really know what's gonna happen. So I highly suggest not eating this crystal geode. Hopefully you guys had fun making this project. If you guys do make this project, make sure you share it with me on Instagram. I always enjoy seeing everyone's finished projects. And if you guys just want to see more of the things that I do on a day-to-day or some of the behind the scenes, follow me on Instagram at RayPahar. Other than that, make sure you check out our last two videos, which were the time-lapse compilation number 4 and our roll-out recycled candy bag pencil case. Thanks again for watching Get Crafty Crafty. Come back next time, take care, and stay crafty.